So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs. In today's session guys, as usually I will bring to you some more questions from the PIB news which are important for all the government exams. And this is the very first session of the year 2022. So I wish you all a very very happy new year and I wish you a great year ahead. आने वाले साल में आपके पास एक जॉब होनी चाहिए, ऐसा आपका प्लेज होना चाहिए. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन. बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, इफ यू आर कमिंग हियर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, डू सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन. यू कैन ऑल्सो ज्वाइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप. हियर यू विल गेट द पीडीएफ ऑफ दिस सेशन एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो आस्क एनी डाउट. यू कैन ऑल्सो फॉलो मी ऑन इंस्टाग्राम. हियर ऑल्सो यू कैन आस्क एनी डाउट. दिस इज माई इंस्टाग्राम आईडी. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन विच सेज, नेम द 100 डेज कैंपेन लॉन्च्ड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन. Now, who is the Minister of Education? It's Mr. Dharmendra Pradhan. And he is also the Minister of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. To promote joyful reading culture among children by ensuring availability of age-appropriate reading books for children. Now, this is a 100 days campaign program to promote joyful reading culture. And remember, the name of the program, guys, is what? Padhe Bharat Campaign. The name of the program is what? Padhe Bharat Campaign. And it has been launched to promote joyful reading culture, as the question says, among children by ensuring the availability of age-appropriate reading books for children. Remember that this campaign will focus on children studying in Balvatikas to class 8. It will run for 100 days starting from 1st January 2020 to 10th of April 2022. Not 2020, 2022. And it will focus on Indian languages including mother language, mother tongue, local languages, regional languages, etc. Alright, so that's why the correct answer is what? Padhe Bharat, option B. And of course, this campaign is in line with the new education policy 2020 that was launched in the year 2020. So option B is the correct answer. Now let's move ahead to question number 2. According to ITC, trade map data 2021, worth how much amount of wheat did India export in the year 2020? 2020 mein India ne kitna wheat export kiya? This question can be asked in your NABARD exam and the upcoming NABARD interviews also. And I congratulate those people who have cleared the NABARD phase 2. And now, ab aapke paas time hai ki pura gear up ho jana chahiye aap logo ko interviews ke liye. So this question is relevant to NABARD and IBPS SO ka jo exam hota hai jisme agriculture se questions puche jate hain. This is also relevant for that also. So Ministry of Commerce and Industry, which is headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal, has released this data on wheat export. And according to ITC Trade Map 2021 data, wheat exports touched $243 million in the year 2020, which was just $50 million in the year 2016. So you can see how much effort government is taking to enhance the export products from the India. India's wheat exports, remember, are mainly to the neighboring countries. And among all the neighboring countries, it is Bangladesh, which has the largest share of more than 54% of the wheat's export. In 2020-21, the previous financial year, India entered various new wheat markets like Yemen, Afghanistan, Qatar and Indonesia. And also, India is the second largest producer of wheat with a share of around 13.53% of world total production. Now, can you tell me which country is the largest producer of wheat? Write down in the comments. Please write down which country is the largest producer of wheat in the world. So here the correct answer should be, guys, what? Option A, $243 million, because in the year 2020, India exported $243 million worth of wheat. Moving ahead to question number 3, which state government has partnered with Indian School of Business to empower state's forest economy and to create job opportunities through a sustainable development model? Remember, this partnership has been done by the Jharkhand government. The Jharkhand government has partnered with the Indian School of Business to empower Jharkhand's forest economy and also to create livelihood opportunities through a sustainable development model. Remember, under this partnership, an MOU has been signed by the Department of SC/ST Minority and Backward Class Welfare and Department of Forest with Bharati Institute of Public Policy at Indian School of Business. Ek Indian School of Business ke andar ek Bharati Institute of Public Policy hai. Uske saath MOU sign hua hai for this project, for this partnership. And remember, the pilot project for this partnership has been launched in Gumla district of Jharkhand. Gumla district of Jharkhand mein iska pilot project launch hua hai. So So therefore, guys, the correct answer is what? Option E, Jharkhand. Jharkhand's chief minister is Hemant Soren. Party is Jharkhand Mukti Morcha. And the governor is Mr. Ramesh Bais. Ramesh Bais is the governor of Jharkhand. Moving ahead to question number 4. Which of the following countries has become a new member of New Development Bank? Now, New Development Bank, guys, is also known as BRICS Bank. It was started in the year 2014. And currently, there are 8 members. After the inclusion of this country, the number of members in BRICS Bank, in the New Development Bank, is how much? 8. So, the recently added member to the BRICS Bank is Egypt. Option C, Egypt is the correct answer. And which are the 8 members? Brazil, Russia, India, China, South Africa. Then we have Bangladesh. Bangladesh, and then we have UAE and Uruguay, and of course the 8th one is Egypt. And these 3 countries, remember, were added as member in the panel of NDB in the year 2020 in the month of September, 2021 in the month of September. Okay, so let's move ahead to question number 5 then. Which of the following states has become the first state in India to launch digital life certificate system for pensioners, under which life certificate can be submitted by the pensioners using AI-based video verification process? So this is for providing ease to the pensioners. Through this certificate system, the pensioners can submit their life certificate using AI-based video verification process. All right. Remember, this state, guys, is Odisha. Option D, Odisha, is the correct answer. Odisha's chief minister is Mr. Naveen Patnaik, and Mr. Ganeshi Lal is the governor. And Naveen Patnaik is from the party Biju Janata Dal. And of course, Odisha is sponsoring the Indian hockey cricket team. Indian hockey cricket team ka sponsor hai Odisha. And of course, in the 2023 Hockey World Cup is going to be held in Odisha, in Rourkela and Kalinga Stadium. Rourkela and Kalinga Stadium. And this Rourkela Stadium is named after the great Birsa Munda. And remember, this is the world's largest. This is the world's largest hockey stadium in the world. Alright. And in Odisha, you will find Simlipal Tiger Reserve. You will find Bhitar Kanika National Park. You will find Nandan Kanan Zoological Park. You will find Satkosia Tiger Reserve and others. And of course, India's first Blue Flag Certified Beach is also in Odisha and Puri district, which is known as Chandrabhag. So option D, Odisha, is the correct answer. So guys, that's it for the session today. New Year की वजह से बहुत सारे departments जो थे government के बंद थे. Of course, Saturday Sunday था, इस वजह से भी, और New Year पे भी लोगों ने लगता है काम कम किया है. So that's why there are very less news at PIB. So I'll see you in the next session on Wednesday. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care and God bless.